In this particular session, we are going to see how to create and run Servlets 3.0 programs. I mean, Servlets 3.x programs are completely different from Servlets 2.x. So, I'm showing it to you specifically over here. The configuration, execution, everything will be different from Servlets 2.x. What is the difference between Servlets 2.x and 3.x? In the sense, in Servlets 2.x, you will be having one extra file called as deployment descriptor, that is web.xml. To say physically the name is web.xml, technically it is called as deployment descriptor. That particular deployment descriptor will not be available in Servlets 3.0. We will be having annotations instead of this particular web.xml, where this particular annotations will give the flexibility for us to develop and run the programs very easily. When it comes to Servlets 3.0, this will be supported only in latest servers. Apache Tomcat 6.0 or above you need to use. If you go with the older versions of Apache Tomcat, you will not be having one jar file. Let me show you library annotation API. This particular jar file will not be available for you. So, in that cases, you cannot run your Servlets 3.0 because annotations will not be available. So, only I'm telling you, just download Abo 6.0. In my machine, I have configured Tomcat 7.0 and Eclipse Kepler is there. So, I will be using this particular thing for running my Servlet program. Simple Servlet program, I will be showing it to you. Just click on New. Okay. Dynamic web project. First, you can see dynamic web module version. It is 3.0 over here. Click next. Okay, next. Nothing. Generate web.xml deployment descriptor. If you want, you can select it. Otherwise, you can ignore it. In some scenarios, which scenarios that is required in the sense? Let's say if you are using Servlet config, Servlet context, at that time you need to hold your parameters within web.xml only. That cases remains same. At that time, yes, you need to have web.xml for holding some configuration details. At that time you generate it. Otherwise, it is not required. Okay, fine. Click on finish. Okay, it is generated. Web-nf, lib, nothing is there, yes, you can see libraries, Apache, yes, all the jar files are available perfectly over here. Next, here, just right click, new, your servlet, class name, first, I'm deriving the features of HTTP servlet only over here. Next. And URL mapping. Let it be first. Next. If you want to change, you can add it. Otherwise, you can select it and you can edit it also. Select it and edit it also. Instead of first, you can keep something else also. Let me keep it to test. Okay. And click next. Constructors, I don't want any constructor, and I want inherited abstract methods. I don't want do post. Let me have to get that sufficient for me. Click on finish. Yeah, you can just go to prop project. One sec. Window preferences. I will expand it. Font size, let me increase it so that you can view it properly. Okay, fine. Now let me remove this, not required. This is also not required. Okay, this you make it public. Okay, and you can see the packages which are derived over here. Servlet annotation, web servlet has been derived. This is one extra thing which is required in servlets 3.0 because we are using annotation web servlet. That means it is almost similar to your Spring concepts. In Spring also you will be learning these kind of concepts, where right now URL pattern, you don't need to create a web.xml servlet mapping URL pattern. Those Hangama is not available right now, directly web servlet. If anybody hits the URL as slash test, immediately control will be hitting to this. If they are calling specifically to the get method or post method, respective methods will get executed. Okay, res, res. One sec. Response dot get writer dot println. Hello. Okay, this is what the program which I wanted to just display hello in the center of your web page. That's it. You just type this, and you want to create one HTML file. Let me create a HTML or JSP file, as we are aware of JSP already. So let me go with the HTML. Okay, index. By default, any of the projects will be starting up with index, so I prefer to go with index.html, otherwise index.jsp or something like index.html. Okay, form action. What is the web servlet URL pattern? Slash test. Okay, copy this, and yes, you can add this dot extra for relative path. And I want once input type equal to submit, k value equal to some, click me. In this example, I'm going to show you simple servlet, where just on click of this particular HTML, control will be redirected to this particular servlet. It displays hello. That's it. Now right click on this simple way, run as, run on server. Okay, now get 7.0. next, here only your servlet is there. If any other servlet projects are available, you can select that and you can remove it. There is no other thing, so this should be available. Click finish. Okay, it is starting up. Okay, done. It is loaded successfully with this particular port address. Click at this place. Hello. This is the way to run your servlets 3.0. If you want to stop the server, click on this. You can stop it off. Yes, server startup stopped. It is stopped. You can see that over here. That's it. That's the end of execution. Thank you so much. Please subscribe to my channel.